to your feet and go to Matthew 6, verse 14 through 18. Word when you get there.
Word.
Matthew 16, verses 14 through 18.
Matthew 16.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
All right, stand up.
Amen. When you get there, I'll hold up. It's on the board anyway. Let me read it off the board, say it to us. And it read, so they say, some say John the Baptist, some Elijah, and other Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. 15. He said to them, but who do you say I am? Simon Peter answered and said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus answered and said to him, blessed are you, Simon, Bar-Jonah.
For flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven.
Can you turn me down some? Let us pray. Dear precious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Heavenly Father, once again, Heavenly Father, for being in your presence, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we take no credit for it, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, I ask that you would think through my mind, speak to my spirit, Heavenly Father, so the sanctuary will get wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of your word. Think through my mind, speak to my spirit, Heavenly Father, and we will get the revelation of what it is that you have for us today, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, I ask that will be none of me and all of you today, Heavenly Father. And after all said and over, Heavenly Father, we will have freedom. We give praise, glory, and honor for it in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Amen.
I want to talk to you today about mindset. And I decided to do this mindset subject because for the last 2 years, at the beginning of the years, I've been dealing with my family and dealing with death for the last 2 years now. The first month of January. Last year we lost 3 or 4 in January. This year we lost 3 and 4 already in January. And you gotta figure out my mind. How can I receive that right now? In order to receive anything by my way, we got to develop, key word, develop a kingdom mindset.
Amen.
Okay. Let's take a look at the definition of develop. To uncover, to unfold, to lay open, to disclose, or make known something concealed or withheld from notice. And I want you to hold on to that, because it's okay, a big part of it. Okay? As a Christian, we must put first thing first by establishing a kingdom mindset.
All right. Mm-hmm.
It's easy to become distracted by the world. Why? Because the world has so much to offer that's not good for us. And us, as being truly blessed, we can receive from the world better than we can from the Word of God because of our mindset.
Uh-huh.
See, we've been trapped in our mind so long when we was out there in our addiction and everything, we didn't know how to develop a mindset for anything else.
That's right.
We developed a mindset for addiction when we was out there. See, it takes time. Every great man, even in the Bible, had to develop a great mindset to do what God had called him to do.
Sure did.
Even look at Moses. And I just love Moses because he had so much that he had to do that was put on him. And God told him to go get my people and lead them out of Egypt.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Right then, the wheels start turning. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. I'm going to get my people and lead them out of Egypt. Right. He first had to develop Moses' mindset to be a leader.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Mm-hmm.
For him to go get him instructions, to get all these people to lead me. Mm-hmm. So Moses had to develop a kingdom mindset. What Jesus was saying, he said it to Peter in Matthew 16 and 8, 16, 18. He said, Jesus said something to the effect of Peter, but more directly. He said, and I say unto thee, that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. 8 and 19, and I will give unto the keys the kingdom of heaven, and whosoever shall be bind on earth to be bound on heaven, and whatsoever shall be loosed on earth to be loosed in heaven.
That's right.
So what it was, when Jesus got Moses to go deliver his people from Egypt, he had to develop his mind for what he was finna go through. He had to go face the Pharaoh.
Yeah.
And he had to go face all the negativity that the Pharaoh had, and he still had to have the mindset of Christ to fulfill what Christ had called him to do.
Amen.
Just like us. You was called. Each and every one of us was called for an assignment.
That's right.
I think Pastor Lou said something about it today. Satan got an assignment for each and every one of
you.
It's your choice to develop the mindset to follow Christ and not Satan. You can follow Satan or you can follow Christ. But I guarantee you, if you develop that mindset of Satan, you have no life. There's no life in you. But God said, I'm going to take you and I'm going to give you the keys to heaven if you just follow me. Stay with me now, what Jesus said. Jesus said he was making it known. We're back to that development. Yeah. And that development said unknown. He was making it unknown to Moses what he was about to do for Moses. And even when Adam and Eve was in the garden, heard this morning too, they had a choice.
That's right.
They had a choice to eat from all these trees. They ate from one tree that they weren't even supposed to eat from. Because they didn't have a mindset of Christ yet. Because hey, that was the first one in the garden. See, now when he was start to develop them in the garden, it was kind of too late because they already ate from the tree already.
Yeah.
So now we got to develop another mindset. Man, y'all got to get with this. You got to develop another mindset. When it ain't going right with the first mindset, you got to get that mindset of Christ so you can get on the right page. You can't continue to stay on the same mindset that we stay on when we is in our mess.
Come on now.
See, when Pastor Bruce and Pastor Pat went to the jail, they had a mindset of they were finna deliver some people.
Come on. Amen.
And the only way they can deliver y'all is get y'all up in here.
Yeah, right.
They can't deliver you from jail.
That's right.
God can deliver you from jail, but God sent his soldiers.
Come on.
Yeah. Just like Satan sent his soldiers.
Yeah.
God sent his soldiers.
Yeah.
My God. Somebody that you have already developed the mindset of Christ.
Uh-huh.
Get a revelation. Check this out. You know what I'm telling you about the beginning of when we was as I was losing loved ones. You know, when you lose loved ones, and I lost my one of my relatives, this month was a pastor that I lost. Now you gotta realize this, catch on now, I'm finna give you something. You know, when he was on his dying bed, even when we call ourselves, even when we cry out to the Lord, we got that fragrance. By his stripes,
we are healed. That's right.
Yes. Right? It take us a while to believe that. But we can believe the world said, take this aspirin, your headache will go away.
Come on.
See, we trust in the world more than we trust in the Word of God. Let's get back to this. By my stripes, you are healed. And I'm pretty sure my cousin, pastor, said, by my stripes, I am healed.
Yeah, that's right.
But the Lord still took him. But when you say, by my stripes, you are healed, it just don't mean being on earth healed.
That's right.
He healed because he ain't got no more bills. He ain't got no more trouble on this earth. He can move forward. He's on what we trying to get to. Despite his rights, he's healed. He's healed now. That's a revelation for you. You just got to catch on to it. We got to be a spiritual revelation. So while we be speaking that, by my stripes we healed, but he still died. You still healed though. That's where our mindset come in. We got to develop that kingdom mindset. Not this earthly mindset. And we can continue to stay on this earth, we continue to think like this earth.
We of this world. We in this world, but we not of this world. And until you believe it, you will continue to stay in that same mindset. Sometimes you got that mindset, just like Bruce Lee said, you got to get off on the exit. You be not a highway, lost. Sometimes you just got to exit.
Okay.
To develop a kingdom mindset. Stay with me now. I ain't gonna be for you so long. I'm gonna give you something, then I'm gonna run. Let's go to Matthew 16:25. Then Jesus said to his disciples, if anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Verse 25. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. 26. For what a profit is it for a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what will a man give to exchange for his own soul? Now, here go another scripture that Jesus is trying to make us learn how to develop a mindset for Christ. I give you everything in the world. It ain't gonna do you no good.
That's right.
And that's what he's saying. What good do it do if you gain the whole world and lose your soul? So, I'd rather lose my soul?
Nope.
Trying to get everything in the world?
Uh-uh.
I gotta develop that kingdom mindset that I know where my riches and my glory lies, that I can enjoy.
That's right.
You only can enjoy this for a while. Because he's going to call you one day, you got to go. Ain't going to be no telephone call talking about, hold on, Jesus, I got another call. So he's coming to get you. Because we live in this world, but we're not of this world. He said, hey, do a good work until I return, he said.
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
He didn't say, I'm going to do all the work. He said, you.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Come on now.
But the only way we're going to do that, we got to develop kingdom thinking. And the only way we're going to develop kingdom thinking is the word of God.
Right.
Any other word won't do you.
Right.
I was telling somebody the other day, they were talking about somebody was giving them a word. And he talking about a believer. I told him, you ain't got to receive every word somebody give you.
That's right.
Every word somebody give you ain't for you.
Amen.
That's right.
You got to believe and receive what you really want to get out of it.
That's right.
And all you got to develop this thinking. And I'm going to shoot that all the way. Develop. Because develop says, to uncover, unfold, to make known.
Right.
Ooh, thank you, Holy Spirit. My God. When I'm going back to Pastor Booth. When they went back to the jail to go get people, they was going to get you from the jail to bring you back up here to the WPP to make Christ known to you.
Amen.
Get a revelation made known to you. That's what it said to develop. They developed, y'all.
Right.
Into human beings again, once again. Because you know we wasn't never human once we was out there in our mess. We was always out of character.
Right.
We could have got an acting job, some of us. We went through the things we did once we was out there. Amen, hallelujah. Some of us still can get some acting jobs. Because you're acting, you're not developing, you're acting up in here. You ain't developing no kingdom mindset.
Come on.
You got to study and be in your word daily. And it still ain't enough.
Yeah.
We got to learn to do something with this thinking that we do. This is some crazy, outlandish thinking.
Right.
But if you let this thinking get your hold of you, you out of control. You know they say kill the head, kill the body. So if you think with the head, you're going to need your body.
Yeah, come on.
Okay.
Think in the spirit.
Uh-huh.
Let's think in the spirit. We can't do nothing outside the spirit.
That's right.
You can't do nothing. You can't do nothing with Christ, without Christ. You can't even develop the kingdom. You're going to develop the worldly thinking once you keep doing the same thing. It's repetitive.
Yeah.
You go to jail, you get out, you do the same thing.
Come on.
Because you have developed that same old thinking that you went in there with.
Come
on. I went in there with the same mindset. I'm coming out with the same mindset. Because I'm used to this. This ain't thing my mind knows. Because I ain't been developing it to do anything else. Get into the Word of God and start developing a kingdom mindset.
Kingdom mindset. Amen.
Amen.
So how do we start developing the kingdom mindset? Romans 12, 1 and 2.
Yes, sir.
And it read, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercy of God, that you present your body a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable servant. He's going to be your reasonable servant if you present yourself.
Right.
And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. By the renewing of what?
Your mind.
So what he's saying is that if I be transformed by my mind, I'm developing a kingdom mindset.
That's right.
That you may prove what is that is good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Yes.
He's going to prove, God's word is always going to prove to you that you are, he's accepted you.
Thank you, Jesus.
We go out here in the world, we accept everything that the world throws at us. Everything. Can't say we don't. We accept negativity, we cool with it.
Yeah.
We don't accept boundaries, we cool with it. We don't accept authority, we cool with it. Sometime in your life, you got to develop that kingdom mindset that we got to start accepting authority figures, laws, rules. It's a must. You can't go forward. You can't go forward. You're going to stay stuck.
Right.
I don't like to be stuck.
No.
You ever get stuck in the mud?
Yeah.
In the snow?
Yeah.
Now you got to go out there and get dirty. You got to get dirty. You can't get dirty with God. You're going to always stay clean.
That's right.
You're going to always look good in the presence of God.
That's
right. Developing now. Right now, you gonna be. I'm going to develop a mindset and you a different mindset before by the time we leave. Because, you know, it tells us that the way that to be transformed is to learn and live Christ-like. Mm-hmm. By the renewing of our mind, put off old negative thoughts, emotions. Oh, we big on emotions.
Yep.
Everybody, it say something wrong with me and our feelings. Ooh. Them called emotions if you didn't know.
Okay.
That's said no. Here come your emotions. Because some of you act like you ain't never heard no before. You know, all you heard all your life was no.
Yeah.
But when you got an authority figure saying no, that God's in place in your life, now you want to be offended. Ooh, that's another word, being offended. Man. You can't be offended and have a kingdom mindset. You got to take it and receive what you receive out of. Take what out of it what you can use and move on. Don't take it off if it all don't pertain to you. Take what God gave you and use it. Okay, man. It said, let's go to Ephesians. Oh, man, this is Ephesians 4, 22 to 24. It said, that you put off concerning your former conduct, the old man which grows corrupt according to the deceitful lusts and the renewing of the spirit of your mind. 24. And that you put on the new man which was created according to God in true righteousness and holiness. Let me tell you something, man.
Yes.
And this let me know right here what our presence is seen. I'm not going to get into politics, but I'm going to let you know that we need to develop a new mindset for 2017 with this presidency. You see what he's doing? Stopping people at the airport already. Hey, but you know what? We can't worry about what Donald Trump do.
Amen.
Donald Trump didn't give me victory though where I'm at today. And he didn't get it, he didn't take it. This was already predestined.
That's right.
This man was predestined to be our 50-something president. It was already written before we was born. But it's not our job to try to figure out what he gonna do. It's our job to stay in position and develop a kingdom mindset so when we leave here, we know where we going. If we stay here and want to get on by Donald Trump, what he ain't doing, the Bible said, God said, I judge.
That's right.
So now, all of us been judging since the presidency came through.
Yes.
Because that's that mindset we had that we've been thinking. That he ain't the man for us. God put him in, he in the office for a reason.
Yes, sir.
We may not like it. I don't care if they take the vote over again, he's still gonna be president. Because he's already predestined. See, we gotta get out that mindset about what you figured out, what he trying to do. What you doing? To get to the kingdom.
Sitting there worrying about Trump?
That's it. Trump can't do it. He ain't gonna do it. We gotta trust and rely on our Lord and our Savior. He got us this far, he gonna keep taking us. We gotta stay on that same track every day. Even when we run up against something, and yet, develop to uncover, to make known. Develop. We got to start develop. Better relationship with Christ.
That's right.
Key word, develop. Better relationship with our spouse. Better relationship with our kids. Better relationship with our neighbors.
Come on now.
We got to develop all of these things to be Christ-like. How are we going to call ourselves Christ-like if we ain't doing the thing that God asked us to do? He going to give us the tools. You carpenters, you masons in here. You can't go to work without your tools because the job won't get done. You just be sitting there. So that's why God gave us tools, the Bible, basic instructions before leaving earth, so we can develop kingdom mindset so when we leave earth, we know where we're going. We can't sit on it. Hey, just like everybody keeps saying, every week, talking about gifts. Everybody got a gift in here.
That's right.
Everybody got a gift. But you got to get up off of it to develop it.
Yep.
It ain't going to develop back then. Don't nothing just sit there and grow but a seed in the ground. But then you got to water it.
Come on.
For it to develop what it will be. So the word of God is going to water you, sprinkle you, and it's going to develop you into what you are called to be.
Amen.
Men and women of God. Not addicts and abysses. Not addicted to everything out on the street. Man, wouldn't it, man, it'd be great, man, if we can get addicted to Christ like we are addicted to drugs.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Running around the corner in the street with the Bible.
Ah.
Man, wouldn't it be great, God? Thank you, Jesus. Be addicted to something like that. That would be good. I'm addicted to Christ. What kind of habilitation would we need for Christ? Huh? What kind of habilitation would we need for Christ, huh?
That's right.
Take a hit of Christ. Ooh, I'm filled with the Holy Ghost now. Man, come on. Hey, you got to eat. Hey, and that's where kingdom thinking come from. We got to think outside the world. Outside the world. Keep thinking outside the world. Think about when we go to heaven.
Yes.
I think Pastor Corey said something about a vehicle. You can't take none of this material stuff with you.
Okay.
All these little vehicles you got.
All the jewelry we got.
That's a, you know what it is? That's another person inheriting when you leave. Can't take it with you. But in our mindset, in the world, our mindset, we're going to ride these wheels and then fall off. You don't even know if you're going to wake up tomorrow. But we put so much trust into this world that we can't even trust a little simple word of God. Seek He. He said, seek me. Stop searching the world, start seeking me. And I'm going to give you everything you ask for.
Yes.
But first of all, you got to develop this thinking, this Christ-like thinking. I got to start thinking like Christ in order to be like Christ, in order to be the image of Christ. Whatever you think, this is what you're going to be. If you think you can't do it, you ain't going to be able to do it. You want to commit suicide, you think about suicide, you might do it one day. So I think Pastor Bruce said this 2 weeks ago. Put a voice on your face.
Yeah.
Where your faith at?
Yeah.
Where your faith at in the Word of God?
Yeah.
We got so much faith out here in the street with these people in the street that we ain't got faith in the Word of God. We let the world overtake what God is saying to us. Because now, we like James. Let's go to James. 1:8. When you got letting the world lead you, and fighting Christ, you get tossed. You get tossed to and fro. I don't know what to do. So you know what James said is? James. Yeah. James 1:8. Double-minded man? Read it for yourself. This is true. This is the word of God. This ain't one that just made up. This is scripture.
That's right.
He is a double-minded man, unstable in all your ways. He didn't say some of the ways. He said everything you do, you're going to be unstable in.
Yep.
On your job.
Yep.
Everything you do, you're going to be unstable if you don't transform your mind into a new way of thinking. See, it's time for all that old thinking to go. You need to just get a dump truck out there and put all that old thinking in it and draw it on off. And then start developing kingdom thinking up here in the WPP and the TPP. See, you know, the Bible said when two or three are gathered, there he is in the midst. Let's get when 500 or 600 of us is thinking like him, what we can do.
That's right.
But we got to develop that kingdom thinking that we can do this.
Yeah.
Yeah, I said the same thing I do, you can do. Matter of fact, you should be greater than I am.
Yeah.
Look how much credit he giving us. We can't even give him that much credit. We try to take credit for things that he done that we say we done.
Come on now.
That ain't no development, no kingdom thinking. That's still worldly thinking. Because I can do it on my own. Look, just take a look back. Two, three, I'm going to keep it real. Let's keep it 2-3 years. What were we 2-3 years ago?
Come on now.
Some of us don't even really want to remember what we was all the time.
Yeah.
For real, hey, man, if it was a fly on the wall, seeing you back there in them days, you'd be ashamed.
Mm-hmm.
But God didn't come bring you up here to make you ashamed. Mm-hmm. He brought you up here before you could be righteous, set free, delivered.
Right.
Come on. That's right.
Come on.
Like full of the Holy Ghost, set on fire.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's called developing. Everything, you got to develop everything. It don't come overnight.
Yeah.
You got to develop a way to receive when you come up here to the program. Some of them come on the program, oh, I'm going to do this 6 months and I'm gone.
Mm-hmm. That's what they
think. Amen. God don't put no limitation on you. You put limitation on yourself. Because you've been limited all your life. You've had limitation on yourself. Because you got that old worldly mindset. And you know, I'm keep saying this mindset is a terrible thing to waste. For real. You see that commercial with them, hey, this is your mind. This brain on. Man, that's serious out here. If you can't get fed by the word of God, you in trouble.
Big trouble.
You in trouble. Because now everybody can lead you. I want to be led by Christ. The world is easy to be to follow the world. Just like when we were talking about this Sunday school, it's a broad road.
Yeah.
That road I can take 50 or 60 people through. Mm-hmm. That narrow road Jesus Christ calling through, you got to
slide. Come on,
but if you want to get in there though,
yeah.
I'm pushing you out the way. I'm trying to get in there. Lose 20 or 15 more pounds. Get on in there. Get in line. Develop a kingdom thinking.
That's right.
Hey, but renewing our mind is simply changing our thoughts.
That's right.
By actually putting off the old man and putting on the new man.
That's right.
Everything you got on is old. Everything that you did is old.
Real old.
What you gonna do to them? What you gonna do for Christ? He said, your day, every day in Christ is new with him.
That's right.
Every day.
Every day. So what you gonna do for him?
Thank him.
He doing everything you can while you submit.
Right.
Developing. Understanding. You got to start developing to understand why you're in this place. That's another mindset. Ask yourself, why am I here? It was by God's choice. It wasn't by Pastor Bruce.
Come on,
Pastor Pat.
Come on.
God designed this place for y'all.
Right.
Amen.
He knew it was already predestined, just like Trump. God knew that Pastor Bruce, gonna need a place for people like this.
Yeah.
Well, he said, like, what? I ain't gonna give you one, I'm gonna give you two places.
Yeah.
Because they got the mindset of Christ.
Come on.
We need to get on that same boat. We got you. Don't miss the boat. I ain't talking about Noah's boat neither. I'm talking about don't miss the boat of what God is calling you to do. Give them off your gift. Get involved. Be a part of something. Be the solution, not the problem.
Amen.
That's good.
I was a problem a long time, for a long time. I was a problem. Kept me out on the scene, but hey, you done. You done. I'm going to get you for everything I can get you for.
Everything.
But not the mindset I had. My mindset was to wake up and go find me somebody or something that would keep me going through the day. And the word Jesus Christ at that time. Jesus Christ would take me through the whole year. With our mindset thinking in the world, it can't take us through one day. We got to do something about the way we think. Because we can think. Some of us think and don't even react on it. Some of us hear from the Holy Spirit and don't even act on it. Develop that ear for the Holy Spirit. Be sensitive to the Spirit. He's going to speak to you, but are you ready to receive? Have you developed that kingdom mindset to where you can hear from the Lord or the Holy Spirit? It's not about us no more. It ain't about us. If you don't do another thing for me, he done it.
Come on now.
I can fall right here and fall out and die tomorrow. I know my family going to be taken care of. I know I'm blessed. I'm blessed coming in. I'm blessed going out.
Come on.
Yeah. Come on. But I do know where my citizenship lies at, though.
Yeah, come on now.
Do you?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
My citizenship lies in heaven.
That's right.
And I'm going to continue to speak that out, put a voice on my faith, and let them know where I'm going when I leave here. They got a place in my car, man. I already got to be here, but up there, y'all just don't even know.
Amen.
Already got it up there. I got a house.
Amen.
Gold fence around it.
I got an answer.
I'm speaking into existence because I know one day I will be opening up that gate.
Come on.
That pearly white gate, you see it? And streets of gold.
That's right.
Come on. Man, you got to get a revelation, man. The only way we're going to get there, we got to develop in Christ like imaging Christ. Imitating Christ in everything we do. Speak, talk, receive. Got to be Christ-like. Only way we're going to do that is make it known. And the only way you're going to get it made known is through the Word of God.
Amen.
That's the only way. I'm thinking, let's all go. Hold on. Let's go. In conclusion, let's go to Romans 8, 5 through 9.
Praise the Lord.
And it reads, for those who live according to the flesh set their minds on things of the flesh. Mm-hmm. So whatever this say do, I ain't even going to second thought it. I'm going to do it. But that's what my mind thought because it developed on what the world is telling me to do.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
But those who live according to the Spirit, the things of the Spirit, come on, next scripture. But to be carnal minded is death.
That's right.
But to be spiritual minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity, man, against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, nor indeed can be. So then those who are in the flesh cannot please God.
That's right.
I don't care how sanctified, Holy Ghost, food you is. If you ain't right-minded, if you ain't doing Christ-like things, you ain't in the Spirit of Christ, you can't please Him. I don't care if you're pastors, ministers, whatever.
Amen.
If you ain't in the Spirit, you can't please Him. Hey, it don't matter about no title. We still the same as y'all. We just got a title. We still got to live the same way we're trying to make y'all live. God put us in positions to teach y'all how to live.
Right.
And the only way y'all can do that is develop it.
That's right.
And that's why he giving us this.
That's right.
Indeed, the Spirit of God dwells in you. Now, if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he is in his food. That's saying God is denying you. And you ain't got the Spirit. You got my Spirit in you. You ain't my child. You got Satan's Spirit. That's your daddy. Some of them got them kind of spirits.
Uh-huh.
Let's go to verse 9. Oh, it is 9 up there. Now, if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he is not his. How can you say, that's just like, come here. That's just like your mom and your daddy saying, you ain't mine.
Mm-hmm.
That's hard. You go to school with an A. Who come to pick you up? My mom and my daddy, they denied me. But Jesus won't deny you.
No, he won't leave you.
You can sit up in there, he'll come get you.
Yeah,
he gonna get you sooner or later.
Nah.
If you develop that kingdom thinking, he gonna get you.
Yes, he will.
Hook, line, and sinker, just like a fish. Jesus throw that right bait out for you. He gonna catch you. Hey, that's gonna be some of the best baits you got. I'm telling you, you can't get enough of Jesus. There's not enough to go around. But as long as you develop the way of thinking about how to finally get to him, you know, because said no one come to me unless they go to
the Son.
And see, some of your mind can't even wrap around that right now. And I'm keeping it real. That's because we ain't developing yet. We still in the stage of developing.
Yes.
Develop. You know how they say meditate? Meditate is the developing your mindset. When you meditate on the Word of God, it's developing Christ-like image. You have a Christ-like image. You don't believe that, do you? You don't believe that, do you? You don't believe if you start developing a Christ-like mind, you can become the image of Christ in flesh, human being? But it's up to you. It's up to you to start developing and thinking about what God got for you. Stop trying to be so mindful, stop trying to outthink the world. It don't work. You can't outthink the world. You can't outthink God. His thoughts higher than yours and way greater than yours. Stay in position. Start developing a kingdom mindset. So you know where you're going when we leave here.
Amen.
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 That's the message.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen